So in this video, we're going to take a very quick look at ordering fractions, decimals, and percentages from smallest to largest. So to make it easier to order these from smallest to largest, we want to make them all the same type. So we either want them all as a fraction, a decimal, or a percentage, which then makes them easier to compare. So we could convert these all to fractions, but sometimes with our trickier fractions, it can be quite difficult to see which one's smaller and which one's bigger. So for these few examples today, we're either going to convert them all into a percentage or all into a decimal, which are a lot easier to compare the size. So for this first question, we want to order 4 tenths, 2 eighths, 32%, and 0.01 in order from smallest to largest. So for this example, we're going to convert all of these into a percentage. Well, fortunately for us, 32% can stay as it is, because that's already as a percentage. Let's now start from the left-hand side. We've got 4 tenths. We want to write that as a percentage. So we may know what our unit fraction of 1 tenth is as a percentage, and then we can use that to find 4 tenths. But again, we can find an equivalent fraction also. We know that percent means per 100, so can I find an equivalent fraction to 4 tenths, which is over 100? Well, yes, we've multiplied the bottom by 10, which means we're going to multiply the top by 10 also, so that's going to give me 40 over 100. So because we've got 40 parts per 100, that is therefore our percentage. So 4 tenths is equivalent to 40%. Now for 2 eighths. Well, we want to convert that to a percentage, but first of all, we can see that we can simplify that fraction. I can divide the numerator and denominator both by 2. So if I do that, I get a quarter. So this is a very common fraction that we learn the percentage to. This is just 25%. But if we didn't know that, we could also find an equivalent fraction here. We could find an equivalent fraction to a quarter that is over 100. Because all I've done is multiply the bottom by 25, so I have to do the same to the top. So that would give me 25 over 100, which again is our 25%. And then finally, we've got 0.01. We now want to convert a decimal to a percentage. Well, to get from a decimal to a percentage, all we need to do is multiply by 100. So because we're multiplying by 100, all the digits are going to move 2 places to the left. So that's going to give us 1%. So now we've got all of these converted to a percentage. We can now order them from smallest to largest. So looking at our percentages, our smallest percentage is 1%. But I'm going to make sure I use the value that I was given in the question. So our smallest value is actually 0.01. Moving on, the next smallest percentage would be 25%. So I've got to give the value I was given originally, so that's 2 eighths. We've then got 40% and 32%, so it's going to be this 32%. That's what we were given originally, so I can just write 32% here. And then finally, the biggest would be our 40%, which we were given 4 tenths. So those would be our values in order from smallest to largest. So let's have a look at a couple more questions. So again, we want to order from smallest to largest, and we've been given these values. So again, instead of using fractions, I'm going to convert these all into either a decimal or a percentage. So for this one, I'm going to convert them all into a decimal. So 0.9 will remain as 0.9. And then starting from the left-hand side, we've got 75%. Well, to get from a percentage to a decimal, we're simply going to divide by 100. So if I divide by 100, that means all the digits are going to move 2 places to the right. So that's going to give me 0.75. We've then got 7 tenths. So again, we may know what our unit fraction of 1 tenth is as a decimal, and then use that to find 7 tenths. Or we can simply do the division. We can do 7 divided by 10. So because I'm dividing by 10, that means all the digits in that number would move 1 place to the right. So that's going to give me 0.7. And then finally, 4 fifths. Again, we might know what our unit fraction of 1 fifth is as a decimal, and then use that to find 4 fifths. Or we could simply do the division of 4 divided by 5. But what I'm going to do here first is find an equivalent fraction to make the division a bit quicker. If I times top and bottom by 2, 4 fifths is equivalent to 8 tenths. And that's a lot easier to do, because 8 divided by 10, all I'm going to do is move the digits 1 place to the right, That's going to give me 0.8. So now we want to order these decimals. So a good tip here, when we're ordering decimals, is to make sure that they all have the same amount of decimal places. So we can see this 0.75 is to two decimal places. The rest are only to one decimal place. So all I'm going to do is put a zero on the end of all of them. So now they're all to two decimal places. So we've got 0.75, 0.70, 0.90, and 0.80. So looking at the digits after the decimal point, we can see that this 0.70 is going to be our smallest. So we're going to use the original value, which was 7/10. So moving on from 0.70, the next smallest would be 0.75. So using the original value, we have 75%. The next smallest would then be the 0.80, which would use the original fraction we were given, which was 4/5. And then finally, our biggest would be this 0.90. But again, using what we were originally given, we're going to write 0.9 to the original one decimal place. So these in order of size from smallest to largest would be 7/10, 75%, 4/5, and 0.9. So again, for our last question, we want to order these in size from smallest to largest. And again, to make that easy to do so, we're either going to convert them into a decimal or a percentage. So for this one, I'm just going to convert them into a percentage. So I can keep this 21% as 21%. And then I'm going to start from the left-hand side. So to start with, we've got this 0.3. We've got a decimal. We want to convert to a percentage. So to get from a decimal to a percentage, we're simply just going to multiply by 100. So that means all the digits are going to move two places to the left. So that's going to give us 30%. We've now got a third. So again, this may be one that you know off by heart. It's 33.3 recurring percent. So that's one you may know. But if not, you can always do the division to figure it out. We could do 1 divided by 3, and we know we're going to end up with a decimal. So I'm going to put some extra zeros, and I've got my point at the top. So we know 3 doesn't fit into 1, so we carry that 1 over to the next digit. And then 3s into 10 will fit 3 times, as 3 times 3 is 9, leaving us with a remainder of 1. So we're going to have the same thing again. So again, 3s into 10 will fit 3 times with a remainder of 1. So this 3 is going to recur. So we have 0.3 recurring as a decimal. We then multiply that by 100 to get our percentage. So we'd have 33.3 recurring percent. And then finally, a quarter as a percentage. Again, this is a very common one. It's 25%. But again, we can always figure this out by finding an equivalent fraction over 100. Because we can simply multiply the bottom by 25, meaning we'd also do the same to the top. So that's where we get our 25% from. So now ordering these in size from smallest to largest, well, our smallest percentage is 21%. So the value for our smallest is going to be our original 21%. Our next smallest percentage is this 25%. So our original value was our 1/4. So that's going to go there. Our next smallest fraction is our 30%. So we're going to use our original decimal of 0.3. And then finally, our biggest percentage is this 33.3 recurring percent that we've just figured out. So our original value for this was our 1/3. So these, in order of size from smallest to largest, are 21%, 1/4, 0.3, and 1/3. So well done if you followed along with those examples. And that's it for this video. If you want to check out any other videos on working with fractions, decimals, and percentages, then I've left some links to them down in the description, and I've also put a card in the top corner, so feel free to check them out. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are any topics you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments, and I'll try to make some videos on those topics as soon as possible. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.